Hey, this is Jillian Johnsrud. Welcome to our third lesson. This is going to be our second kind of life planning question, just to get a little bit of that big overview to catch all of these ideas of what do we really want our life to look like. And this one we call Ideal Day. So it's very simple. I want you to think about what your ideal day looks like. If you woke up tomorrow and you got to live kind of your perfect mix, what would that look like? And we're going to do this in three parts. I want you to create some of your ideal day, and then what your week looks like, and then year, because there's some things that we do every single day. Let's say every day you want to start the morning with drinking a cup of coffee or a cup of tea if you're like me, and doing a little bit of reading for 20 minutes, and that's kind of a daily part of your schedule. But there's some things you might just want to do weekly, like once a week I get together with friends, or once a week me and my spouse go out for dinner. And then there's some things that fall into a yearly category. Every year we take 3 weeks and we go camping, or every year we take 2 weeks off over the holidays and we really spend it with friends and we have time for traditions, whatever that looks like. And there's a couple areas that I want you to think about specifically. So one of them is work. Where does work, and now this would be work that you enjoy, that's fulfilling and meaningful for you, where does that fit in? In your ideal, let's say you're financially independent. You don't necessarily have to work anymore for income, or maybe just for a little bit of income. How does that fit into your day, week, or year? You know, some people might say, I would love to work for like 3 or 4 hours a day. If I could get a couple hours of just really focused, meaningful, engaged work, that would be enjoyable. Some people say, you know, if I could just do a couple days a week, that would give me all of these other benefits that I really enjoy from work. Or some people might be like, I don't really want to do stuff consistently, but ideally, if I could do a couple big projects a year, that would be really enjoyable. So I want you to think about work. I want you to think about rest. What does rest look like? And that could be sleep or restful activities. Growth. And growth, I also think about creativity. So for some people, this is taking a class or learning a new skill or reading a book or writing or doing something that's creative where they feel like they're learning and they're growing and they're making something. And it's just really interesting and engaging for them. I want you to think about relationships. This could be your nuclear family with your spouse or with your kids, or your extended kind of family, your parents, your siblings, your nieces and nephews, or your friends. How do your relationships fit into your ideal? And the last one we want to look at is your health. And this could be, you know, if you're meditating every day, or if you're going to the gym, or if you walk consistently, or what you're eating, or how you food prep, or any of the things that deal with your mental, emotional, physical health. And just kind of, this just, you know, there's other things you can put in here, obviously. But how do these things fit in? And for some people, you know, even vacations. Vacations might be relationships. Vacations might be rest. Vacations might be growth because they're going to new countries and they're learning new languages and they're traveling and they're exploring and they're really pushing their personal boundaries. But these are the broad categories that I want you to think about. And then the other thing I want you to do after you get all of this done, just two more steps. The first one is, what can you do now? So you know what your ideal day, week, and year is. You know kind of what those groups are. What steps could you start making like this week to start lining this up with your ideal day? Sometimes we go, yeah, I mean, it would be amazing if I could read for 15 minutes before bed. Like in my ideal life, that's what I do. Maybe you can start doing that now. If you say, yeah, my ideal life, I would exercise every day. Maybe we can find a way to start doing that now, even in a smaller scale. I like to make sure that I exercise every day, but when we adopted a sibling group of three from foster care, and man, that first year was crazy. There were so many appointments, it was so stressful, and I couldn't have my ideal, which was like go to the gym and have 90 minutes and work with a trainer and like all these cool things. That wasn't gonna happen. So instead I said, well, I'm just gonna do 6 minutes a day. And I couldn't even do 6 minutes consecutively because I had all these little kids just demanding my attention all the time. But I said I could do 1 minute six times a day. So for a minute I would do squats, or for a minute I would do push-ups or jumping jacks. It wasn't my ideal, but I said this is what I could do now. And I found a little way just to get started, which we'll talk about in the next lesson down the road about testing and scaling. That's how I could get started. And then later, this is what I want you to think about. So if this is your ideal, what do you need to do between now and then that will get you there? What steps would have to fall into place? Because it might take, before you get to like your true ideal day, week, and year, it might take 5 years, it might take 10 years, it might take 15. There might be a lot of stuff that has to happen in order for you to get there. But you could start laying that foundation. You could start taking steps in that direction. You know, if you were the person that said, you know, I would love to do 3 or 4 big kind of projects a year, but then not really do much stuff day to day. You could start working in those industries where that's possible. You could start learning those skill sets. You could start creating other means of passive income that would cover your daily and weekly expenses. You could start building up some investments or paying down debt. There's things that you can say, if this is where I want to go, here are some of the things that are going to have to fall into place to really make that happen. So I encourage you to kind of just spend some time, go, you know, with a friend, with a partner, go through some of those conversation questions, and just to have another person to bounce some of the ideas off of. And I hope that helps. And I will see you in the next lesson. And the next one is one of my favorites, so you won't want to miss it, because we are going to transition to what that kind of meaningful, enjoyable work might look like. Thank you, guys.